welcome, everyone. Thanks for tuning in. We're here at Holy Cross Regional High School in Surrey, British Columbia for the final game of the 2020 BC Catholic Basketball Championships featuring the Vancouver College Fighting Irish and the Holy Cross Crusaders. I'm Kevin Wallsmith doing the play-by-play, and I'm here with Matt McKay, who will be doing my color for the night. So right off the bat, we've got some action inside. Big block by Holtz, but Brent Padilla picks up the rebound and the putback.
Lots of early energy from Holy Cross, playing in front of a packed gym in their own facility. The college Holy Cross matchup in the boys' finals has almost become as much of an annual tradition of the tournament itself lately. The last 5 years, or it's the fifth year in a row, the two schools have matched up in the boys' championship game.
So Logan Mathers picks up his first personal foul, and Soriano at the line shooting two. We've got a raucous crowd here. The home team, Holy Cross Crusaders, always getting great support. And a good good turnout from the Irish faithful.
Soriano with both, Collins dropping back right into the half court.
Olagola into the paint, guarded tightly by Soriano. Over to Fujimura. And we've got a foul here on the Irish. And Soriano picks up his first.
Fouls on number 14, Jason Soriano. His first personal foul, team foul number one.
It'll be interesting to see how the game unfolds here early. College has a definite size advantage over the home team of Crusaders. But both teams do have athletic guards, aren't able to be up and down the court at a pretty good tempo.
So 4-1 lead for the Crusaders. Full court pressure by Holy Cross, handled easily by the Irish. Cruz Dumont guarded by Olagola. Over to Chong. Back inside to Soriano. High low pass into Holtz, guarded by Mathers. Great contest by Mathers. Rebounded by Olagola. In transition up to Padilla. Easy two. Great start for the Crusaders. Irish back down the court quickly. Cruz Dumont guarded by Anim. Pull-up jumper. Long rebounded Olagola. Fujimura, transition three. Short. Irish with the rebound. High dribble by Holtz. Back up to Cruz Dumont, who draws the foul. So we've got Cole Cruz Dumont and Hunter Cruz Dumont looking to make the family connection.
Yeah, older brother Jack is a Vancouver College alum as well as their father John. Father John wanted to play UBC, where their oldest brother is currently playing as well.
Chong for three, that'll go. He's had the hot hand this tournament. Really improved since last year with his outside shooting. Anim over to a slashing Padilla and out of bounds. Padilla calling for a foul.
And the Holy Cross bench staff on the foul there as well.
Anim inbounds to Padilla, guarded by Cruz Dumont. Padilla goes right at him. Flips it over to Olagola. Easy two.
Standing back out in the full court again. Expect to see a steady, if you're at college, you have to expect to see a steady dose of full court pressure for the full 32 minutes of tonight's game.
Tough shot by Cruz Dumont, rebounded by Holtz, who draws the foul.
Stay behind the ball.
Fouls on number 12, Ben Padilla. His first personal foul, team foul number three.
Soriano into the lane, blocked by Mathers. Picked up by Cruz Dumont. Looks to set things up. Ball screen rejected into the lane, and we've got a foul on the ground on Mathers. So that's two on Logan Mathers. And Andre Manganin looks to check in for him.
That's a tough call for Holy Cross. We're going to get a quarter-line foul, given what the refs have called in the first 3 minutes. I mean, it's not out of line with kind of what they've established early. But Mathers definitely is a big piece for them tonight, especially with the size of college.
Away with one there.
Coach Lay's Scrub saying that was a push-off as his own player. Got away with the call, but they can't capitalize on it. Back out to Fujimura. Cross-court pass. And in for three. No good. Rebounded Holtz. Soriano in transition. Lobs it up to Cruz Dumont. A little bit too far. That's a turnover on the Irish. So we've got Holy Cross leading 8-4. 4.5 minutes left to go in the first as Mathers checks back in with two fouls.
The referee's just, Turkey was just getting a confirmation from the ref there. The last foul across actually was on number 10, Olegala, not 9, Mather.
So Shader's breathing a sigh of relief on that one. As Olegala looks to break down Soriano, nice pull up. Chong guarded tightly by Anim. And stolen. Anim in transition, no good. Followed by Fujimura. It'll count. We'll stay here for the and one. TJ Fujimura with the great hustle and follow. As well, draws the foul on Cruz Dumont. Big play for the Crusaders. And he converts the three-point play the old-fashioned way. Chong over to Cruz Dumont. Crusaders look to trap. And we've got a whistle here, not sure why.
There was something on the floor.
So apparently there was some debris on the floor from the fans. Inbounder to Cruz Dumont, over to Chong. Corner Soriano, back out to Cruz Dumont, guarded by Olegala. Soriano, baseline drive, no good. Rebounded, Mathers. Crusaders dangerous in transition. Padilla from Olegala. We've got a timeout here for Vancouver College. So, Holy Cross lead 13-4. A hot start for the Crusaders. What are your thoughts?
Well, if you're Van College, I think at this point you have. If you're Vancouver College at this point, I think you have to be a little disappointed in your effort early on in the game. I mean, coming into the game, you know Holy Cross is going to run. You know that they want to get out of transition, and to basically fall asleep and give up 4 or 5 layups just on a primary break, it's got to be pretty disappointing. I'm sure that's what Coach Scrub right now is working on, trying to correct some of those breakdowns.
So, definitely Vancouver College with a height advantage with hold inside, but Logan Mather's doing a decent job contesting his shots, got a block.
Yeah, Mather's doing a really good job competing, making sure that hold doesn't get an easy catch somewhere close to the rim or somewhere he's comfortable. College so far hasn't adjusted in terms of what they're trying to do, in terms of whether they're trying to get him into ball screen or some high-low action. So it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments they make as the game goes on to try and free up hold. It's 6'9", long, athletic bouncer. He's a real mismatch problem for Crusaders if Van College can find a way to get him the ball.
All right. Well, let's see how things play out here in the BC Catholic Finals 2020 here at Holy Cross. Vancouver College inbounds the ball. Cal Takata and Ben Levy in for the Crusaders. Cruz Dumont over to Jason Soriano. High post, Hunter dropped down to Holtz. Well contested, no good, but he gets his own board anyway. 15-6, 3 minutes to go in the first.
I just kind of like you were talking about there in the timeout, right? College came out with, you know, running a set, trying to get that high-low look and try to take advantage of Mathers being really aggressive on that first side of the post.
Padilla guarded by Cruz Dumont at the elbow. Hand it off to Olegala. Back into the high post, looking to exploit that mismatch. Mather's baseline jumper over Holt. Crusaders up big in the first quarter. Cole Cruz-Dumont guarded by Ben Levy. Flips it over to Soriano. He thinks three. Denied by Olagola. He's coming back. Are you kidding me? Olagola. The easy transition, Deuce.
This is a real dangerous time for Van College. You come into, you know, Holy Cross's gym. Obviously, they've got a pumped up crowd. You know, things aren't going your way early. It's really important. They just, you know, everyone tries just to do their job, not overplay. No one tries to step up and, you know, sort of try to take the game on, you know, on their own back at this point. Just really focus on making simple plays, working together, and trying to just chip away at this early Holy Cross lead.
Yeah, Vancouver College seems a little bit on their heels, and Holy Cross came out guns blazing. So we'll see how things go.
Yeah, and that's something that you have to, I mean, you would think you'd be prepared for, but again, when you're dealing with high school kids, there's a lot of emotion. You know, college does have a lot of younger players, a lot of grade 11, so yeah, this is an environment that a lot of them will have seen a lot. But you know, as a pretty good, as a pretty strong 4A program, it's something they're going to see a lot over the course of the year, whether it's in the See the Sky Championships or at the Langley Event Center, I'm sure later in the year. So, and this is definitely a good experience for them, and definitely a good learning experience, a chance to grow as a team.
So between BC Catholics and their games with St. George's, they're used to raucous crowds, and
yeah, I think it's always a little, you know, I think they're used to that with St. George's games for sure. And, you know, you get them here, but I think it's always a little different. So that's where it's, you know, it's sort of the final. You're playing for something, right? You're playing for a championship, and I think that adds that little extra pressure. It does take a little experience to get used to dealing with that. You know, even if, you know, guys have had success at the grade 8, 9, and 10 level, the varsity level is an entirely different beast. Right? And so it does take some getting used to for those younger players, especially those grade 11s, and they're just sort of finishing the first half of their, most of them, their first year at varsity.
So Cole Cruz-Dumont is good from three. They're looking to claw back here. They're within 10. Parsa Haydarzadeh and also Jackson Finley check in for the Irish. And we've got a foul on Andre Mangonin. So Jacob Holbrook goes to the line shooting two.
No individuals in trouble, foul trouble yet for Holy Cross, but 16 fouls in the first quarter is something that they want to keep an eye on here going forward.
No question on the second. Kyle Tejada over to Olagola. No pressure from the Irish. Looking to play in the half court. Ball screen for Padilla. He slashes. No good. Rebounded by Finley. Cruz Dumont over center. Cruz Dumont over to Cruz Dumont. Jump down to Holt. Easy two. 7-point game. As we approach the final 30 seconds of the first quarter, Crusaders leading 19-12.
Like an offensive foul, Holy Cross. On Padilla. That'll be Padilla's second. We'll see him exit game. Fujimura returning for Holy Cross.
And that's a tough one for the Crusaders. Brent Padilla has been one of the more consistent players the Crusaders have had all year. So they're hoping to keep him out of foul trouble.
Yeah, Padilla's definitely one of the more experienced players in the Crusaders, having played several years. You know, played a key role with the varsity boys team, as well as you know, playing a lot of club basketball, with drive basketball as well. So he's played a lot of experience at a high level.
So the Irish looking to storm back as Hunter Cruz-Dumont scores to bring them back within five to end the quarter. So 19-4 lead for Holy Cross. First half of the game, first half of the quarter was all Crusaders, and Irish looking to storm back a bit.
Holy Cross 19, Vancouver College 14.
Yeah, I mean, if you're Vancouver College, like we talked about earlier, you want to keep your head up. They had some good looks early, didn't fall, and then they gave up some transition layups at the other end. A couple of those easy ones around the rim fell for them later in the first quarter. Holy Cross, on the other hand, were the ones missing out of transition. And it's one of the challenges when you play at a higher tempo like Holy Cross likes to do. If you jump out to that early lead, you know, playing with more possession, at a higher tempo, you have more possessions. It's great, but it also gives your opponents more of an opportunity to crawl back into that game. And so you see that there, right? Cubs just two or three, up and down, quick, minutes of quick flowing basketball, and that big Crusader lead is now down to only five.
Yeah, it really turns into a game of runs, and timing is really important on that. And
you're really hoping that you get more of the runs. You're hoping your runs are a little longer than theirs are.
Yeah.
But it'll be interesting to see what happens here as the game goes on. If it stays tight going into later in the game, the college is able to slow down that tempo a little bit and exploit their highest advantage. And if they do, Holy Cross can respond to that and see if they can score consistently in the half court as they do in transition.
So Vancouver College maintains possession to start the quarter. Baseline drive, Cole Cruz Dumont. Cruz-Dumont with the lane. 19-16 lead for the Crusaders. Olagola breaks down Jackson Finley. He'll draw the foul.
Fouls on number 8, Jackson Finley. That's his first personal foul. Team foul number 1.
It's going back to the last possession there for Vancouver College. You see the difference now than the first couple minutes of the game where the Irish didn't really look to get the ball to Holt. After a few possessions out of that first time out, really looking to try to exploit that mismatch, get the ball to Holt. And now he's taking so much attention away from the Holy Cross defense. Help side rotations are slow. Everyone's so worried about the ball going in there that College is finding not just opportunities for Holt, but open shots for their teammates as well.
So Hunter Cruz Dumont guarded by Ui Olagola over to Finley. Tight defense by Tejada. Good cut by Finley as the ball is bobbled and we've got a jump ball.
Jump ball. That's it. Crusaders.
As TNM checks back into the game for Ben Levy. And TNM, really the heart and soul a lot of the time of this Crusaders team. He's feisty, he gets after it, and just has a lot of heart.
Yeah, I mean, Adam sometimes may get a little bit lost in the box score with some of the highlight plays you get from Magala, but he's a very steady, very solid player for them. Never gets too rattled, never gets too high, never gets too low. Just comes out, does his job, and consistently makes the right play for the Crusaders.
Adam for three, short. Great contest by Cruz Dumont. And here come the Irish. Anim causing all kinds of trouble, forces a steal. Holt coming back for the block. And Andre Manganin picks up the rebound.
There's a couple times here early in the first half where Holy Cross has done a great job of following the ball in transition, never assuming a make. The Irish have really pulled back hard. They contested that first shot, but giving up an easy offensive rebound and put back for the Crusaders. That's more just a focus and sort of mental effort as opposed to physical effort.
And him in the lane draws the foul. So that'll be Finley's second. With Holt hustling back in transition and Anim taking it to the rack, it seemed as if Holt's arm reached up to the top of the backboard for that block.
It very well may have.
Michael Chong checks back in for the Irish. Anim inbound, stolen by, bobbled, recovered by the Crusaders. Olagola backs up, surveys the floor. Looks inside. He's double teamed. Kicks it out to Fujimura. No good on the three. Rebounded Chong. Irish in transition. Hunter Cruz-Dumont. Euro step. Back rim. Rebounded by his brother.
And same play out of this end, right? Holy Cross really needs to get that second or third defender back in transition. Never assuming that there's going to be that make.
So Caldada with a quick transition three, no good. And Holy Cross calls a timeout. Coach Anthony Vicente wants to talk things over.
Yeah, I think coming out of the timeout here, Holy Cross is going to want to look to move the ball a bit more in the half court. They've got okay looks, but in the half court, they're definitely at their best when the ball's moving, where multiple guys are getting their hands on it, switching side to side. We have so many guys that can put the ball on the floor and attack gaps that when the ball does start moving, if they're willing to be unselfish and share the ball with their teammates, someone's going to get up with either a layup or a wide open three pretty much every time down. It's really hard to contest consistently in man-to-man.
And coaches Anthony Vicente and Malachas are really okay with the transition looks, transition kickouts, threes, especially after a forced turnover.
Yeah, I think the big thing is they do a pretty good job, or the players do a pretty good job recognizing what's a good shot for each of them, and not really forcing things outside of that comfort zone. And in transition, they're really good at finding those shots. In the half court here, right early, they've struggled a little bit, and I think a little bit more ball movement would open up some of those opportunities for them.
All right, so we'll see the adjustments here made by the Crusaders after the timeout. As the Irish crossover center, double team coming. Baseline drive, good. Cole Cruz-Dumont as Ben Levy took an elbow to the face. Looking a little shaken up. 2-point game here. 5 minutes left to go in the second. Gola Gola guarded by Jason Soriano. Picks it over to Mangonin, pump fake. Drift pass, out of bounds. Turnover.
And you see there where just the presence and the size of Holt causes some disruptions for the Crusaders. Coach Vicente wanting to see Mangonin go up strong there on the front side. But obviously with the presence of Holt, he's looking to find shooters on the backside instead of trying to force a shot that he's afraid of getting blocked.
So we're all tied up here. 4:39 left in the second quarter as Irish force another turnover. Cruz-Dumont in transition. The finger roll is good. Irish take the lead, 24-22.
Yeah, the ball's still kind of continuing to stick a little bit in the half court for Holy Cross. We're getting kind of one or two passes into a shot, one or two passes into a turnover.
Swarming defense by the Irish. Flip shot from the high post. Anim, no good. Tough look as the Irish come storming back. Michael Chong for three. Yes. He's 2 for 2 on the night. Feeling it. Lagola drives in the lane. Kick over to Mangonin. Back to Lagola. He's open. Why not? Air ball. Rebounded by Holtz. Soriano dumps it back into the middle of the floor. Nobody's there. We've got a 2-on-1. Anim. Left-handed layup. No good. Followed by Lagola. And we've got a foul. Big play there for the Crusaders.
Hunter Cruz-Dumont with the foul.
So Coach Lloyd Scrub asking for a timeout before Gola Gola will look to complete the three-point play. And Brandon Fuchs checking in for the Crusaders. So Irish in the lead.
Yeah, it's been a good little turnaround here. I think if you're Vancouver College, I think you're pretty happy with how the second quarter's gone. The energy's been up, the effort physically, mentally has been a bit better. Some of those early mistakes, whether it was nerves or jitters, seem to have calmed down a little bit. I think if you're Holy Cross, you want to see the ball move a bit more. You want to be a little bit better on the ball defensively. In the second quarter here, they got beat straight line a couple of times, and that's made those help rotations really difficult and given up some open threes and some layups. I think they're still quite worried about the presence of Holt. They're not wanting to rotate off Holt and give up the big dunk. So it'd be interesting to see what kind of adjustments Holy Cross makes in terms of help, but also it really just comes down to being better on the ball in that initial drive.
It's subtle, but you can really see the body language shift there. Vancouver College picking up a whole bunch of confidence.
Yeah, I think it's, again, you're coming into the other school's gym, big crowd, everyone's kind of yelling, big introductions, heart rate's up, everyone's excited, and they missed a couple early ones, and I think that was kind of tough. But once the first couple shots fell, you can see them almost like the weight just kind of release itself, and Vancouver College is definitely playing much more free, much more flowing here in the second quarter.
So Olagola with a single free throw, he knocks it down. So 2-point lead for the Irish. Double team comes. Chong over to Soriano, wide open three, no good. Rebounded James Marujo. In transition, right inside to Fuchs. Pump fakes, draws the foul, can't finish. So we'll go to line for two. That foul is on Cole Cruz Dumont.
Foul's on number two, Cole Cruz Dumont. His first personal foul, team foul number four.
First one rims out. Good on the second. 1-point game. 3 minutes to go in the half. Olagola with the steal. Pump fakes, finishes, and the Crusaders take the lead. 28-27.
Yeah, you can see there, the college is definitely looking to get the ball into Michael Chong's hands early against pressure. And when they've been able to do that, it's been successful. But from time to time, it's just whether it's sort of mental error or not, Chong gets back to half court, and other guards are struggling to attack that initial pressure from Holy Cross.
The ball rebounded by the Crusaders, but turned over right back to the Irish. College having a little trouble setting things up with the pressure from the Crusaders as Chong attacks, kicks it over to Cruz Dumont.
Diogala's second.
Yeah, Zui picks up his second. So Olagola and Padilla both with two fouls here in the first half.
And it'll be interesting to see as we go along here how college continues to handle that pressure. You're going to see it for the entire game with Holy Cross. And one of the things that does work in their advantage is the guards they bring off the bench do also bring a good job of creating that pressure defensively in the full and the half court. And I think it's more of a challenge for the opposition to bring in multiple ball handlers who can handle it than it is for Holy Cross to bring in defenders that can bring that pressure as well. Start to see it manifest in spots here already in the first half, whether it's just careless passes going out of hands or being a little off target, out of bounds.
Marujo for three, no good. Rebounded Soriano. Soriano, a two-sport athlete, looking to take his talents to UBC next year for football. As Hunt Cole, Cruz Dumont draws the foul on T. Annam.
Holy Cross bench was looking for the travel there first. They may have had a good case for it. But regardless, Cruz Dumont at the line for two.
No good on the first. So he'll miss both with a chance to tie, but rebounded by Holt, stripped by Marujo. Great defense by the Crusaders. Hold a goal and a transition. Fouled by Soriano.
That'll be bonus.
Fouls on number 14, Jason Soriano. His second personal foul.
And John Calica sees his first minutes of the night.
Irish number 5, John Salita.
As does Nosa Ejizode looking to sub in. Two from the line for Olagola.
Number 1, Nosa Yose.
So Ui Olagola will take a rest probably for the remainder of the half. Holt guarded by Fuchs. Back up top. Chong, quarterback in the offense. Guarded tightly by Anim. Over to Cole Cruz-Dumont. Chong in the corner, baseline drive, we've got a foul. Anim will pick up his second in a matter of 1 minute. Oh, correction, James Marujo called. So.
Number 5, James Marujo. His first personal foul, team foul number 3.
Lucky for Anim there. Adar's day over to Dumont into Cruz Dumont into Holt. Once again, we've got a foul.
This one on Fuchs.
Hey,
it's not a good foul for Fuchs to take. I mean, at that point, Holt has position. There's nothing really he can do to stop the catch. I mean, he's much better off just trying to play the catch, defend, and you know, those teammates bring help if need be.
Here's Dumont, pump fakes. Calica, Michael Chong. Cole Cruz Dumont for 3. Long, loose rebound picked up by the Irish. Just over 1 shot clock to go here for the Irish. Perhaps going for the 2-for-1 opportunity. Calica, over Cruz Dumont, cross court pass, we've got a foul.
Marujo with his second.
Two quick ones for Marujo.
And that'll send Vancouver Polish to the line here for 2.
Coach Anthony Pazente looking to get a timeout if they score. Maybe set up a last play for the half as Calica connects on the first. Two-point game. 25 seconds to go in the half. Marujo guarded by Cole Cruz Dumont. Anim looks to set things up for a last shot opportunity. Fuchs comes to ball screen for Anim. Anim drives in the lane. Yes! Great take by Anim. Great finish for the Crusaders as they lead 32-28 at the half. Your thoughts on the first half?
Well, I talked about, I mean, it definitely was a game of runs. You know, when the tempo's up, you know, the game definitely tilts in Holy Cross's favor in a hurry. They've been very good in transition. When Vancouver College has been able to control tempo a little bit more and slow the game down, it's been much more of a challenge for the Crusaders on both ends. And it's been kind of the story of their season this year. When they've been able to sort of impose the tempo they want on teams, they've been very, very successful. Where they've struggled, the games they've struggled, or even games that they've won where they've had some rough patches, it's when teams have been able to make it more of a half-court game on both ends. And that's just personnel, and that's just, you know, the style of guys are comfortable with. So I think the second half here is going to be a lot about trying to extend that pressure, trying to keep the tempo high and get those easy looks in transition, and then force college to play a bit faster than they're willing to. You can see when they play up tempo, the Irish have a hard time finding hold and in the half court. When the game slows down, obviously everything kind of flows towards him, or he always has the attention of the Holy Cross defense, regardless of the ball's coming to him or not. So it's much more of a challenge for them to have to guard the ball in the half court. So we'll see who can come out here and sort of establish the tempo they want, who can impose their will on the other team here early in the third quarter. I think that'll be, with a tight game like this, I think the start of the third is going to be pretty key in terms of who's going to come out on top tonight.
All right. All with that said, let's take a short break here, and we'll pick things up at the beginning of the third quarter. See you then.
I guess I'm going to eat. I got like 3 minutes, so. Well, I got six, but yeah. All right, good stuff.
Touch me, 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 tou
That was actually a 3. Doesn't matter.
Good. So welcome back to the second half of the boys' final of the 2020 BC Catholic Basketball Championships between the Holy Cross Crusaders and the Vancouver College Fighting Irish. Once again, I'm Kevin Wallsmith, and I'm here with Matt McKay. Crusaders led for a good portion of the first half, and College took the lead momentarily, but Holy Cross stormed back at the end there, so it's 32-28 as we begin the second half.
And College opens with possession. Fairly equal scoring for College in that first half. Colt lays in off the glass for two. First 9 point. Cole Cruz Dumont and Holt both 9 on the night so far for College. Holy Cross's scoring was mostly led by Uwe Iguodala, 14 in the first half. A little bit of that out of necessity with some of the foul trouble particularly to Brett Padilla early in the game. So,
as Cole Cruz Dumont drains the three, assisted by his brother. As the Irish take the lead, 33-32. There's no good. Rebounded by Holt.
Yeah, we'll see if Holy Cross is able to reestablish that tempo and intensity they had in the first half. Now they've got Padilla and Mather back in the game. Guys who came in after they got in foul trouble definitely played hard, but they do lose a bit in terms of athleticism and size when those two go to the bench.
Olagola. 16 points on the night for Olagola. Soriano, back up top to Chong, floater, short, rebounded by Soriano, great play, Jason Soriano.
Yeah, and everyone in the stands always gets on players for giving up the offensive rebound off an air ball, but realistically, they're one of the hardest rebounds to kind of judge. Everyone's looking at the ball, expecting the ball to come off the rim, trying to find position, and all of a sudden the ball comes 3 feet short, and it has a sort of magic way of ending up in the hands of the offensive team for an easy two.
Yeah, especially the offensive players just running downhill as Cruz Dumont extends the lead, 39-34. Quick shot by Anim, no good. Tipped out of bounds, so we'll stay here.
You know, Holt doing a good job challenging and altering shots around the rim, but that's the second or third time tonight where, you know, he's had an offensive rebound, brought it down early, and failed to strip it.
Brent Padilla with the lay-in. 39-36 lead, Vancouver College over Holy Cross. Corner three, no good. Rebounded Olagola.
The College is sagged off Soriano there on those corner threes and been willing to give him that three the entire night. At some point, he's going to have to knock a couple down for College if they're going to make him pay for that.
Jackson Finley checks back in for Vancouver College.
Number 8, Jackson Finley.
Michael Chong hearing it from his coach. Perhaps not saying things up quite like he likes. Cruz Dumont in transition. Dishes over to his brother. Count it.
Cruz Dumont.
5 points for Cole Cruz Dumont. 4 points for Hunter Cruz Dumont in the second half. Anim, baseline drive, dish it to Padilla, he'll draw the foul. Cruz Dumont picks up his second foul. And Padilla will shoot two.
And in the opening part of the second half here, I mean, the tempo and the pace has definitely been, you know, in Holy Cross's favor. But especially being the Irish, we've done a better job, again, you know, converting those opportunities in transition. Holy Cross hasn't done a very good job of stopping the ball early, you know, allowing Cruz Dumont to get to the rim pretty much whenever he wants here early in the second half.
Padilla, one of two from the line. Ball bubbled by the Irish, but they maintain possession. Hunter, Cruz Dumont, guarded by Olagola. Drives baseline, steps through, draws the foul. He'll go to the line to shoot two. That's Padilla's third foul.
It'll be interesting to see here what the Holy Cross coaching staff does. Three fouls halfway through the third quarter. But, you know, Padilla hasn't played a ton tonight. He is grade 12. He is one of your veteran guys, more experienced guys. And at some point, you have to be able to play with a little bit of foul trouble.
So looks like he'll stay in. 43-37 lead for Vancouver College. Fujimura along the baseline. He'll draw the foul. A lot of fouls to start the half here. Soriano picks up his third.
Fouls on number 14, Jason Serrano. That's his third personal foul.
Parsa Haydarzadeh today checks in for Vancouver College. Olagola turns it over. Hunter Cruz Dumont tripped up by Anim.
That should be going to a free throw line, but I don't think they're going to give it to him.
Fouls on number zero.
Cruz Dumont had definitely picked up before contact. I think Coach Scrub there had a pretty good case.
Yeah. Nonetheless, it'll be on the ground, so Irish inbounded on the baseline. Turnover, looks like we'll get an over and back call. And the Crusaders looking to capitalize.
Some of that consistent pressure paying off there for Holy Cross. No easy cash, no easy passes. You know, sometimes you get those unforced turnovers start to pile up a little bit here for college. We'll see what happens if that continues here in the second half.
Padilla blocked by Holtz, rebounded by Mathers. 3 seconds on the shot clock. No good for Anim. Holt with the rebound. Stolen by Olagola. He's looking to go coast to coast. He throws it down. 43-39 lead for Vancouver College. Olagola, always electric in transition. Blocked by Mathers. Stolen by Cruz Dumont. Looking to go coast to coast. He'll lay it in. 45-39. 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. Nonstop action here in the BC Catholic Finals. Lots of transition buckets. Tough defense. Olagola looks to go behind the back. Stolen. As Finley has trouble picking it up. He'll gather it, kick it out to Holt. He'll go for three. No good. Rebounded by Anim. Surrounded by Irish. And we'll take a timeout. So, a bit of a flurry of action there.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot going on, but not a lot of it was very productive.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of questionable shots and part of that's a little bit of fatigue. Part of that it's a little bit of pressure. I mean, it comes from a good place where guys want to step up, you know, and make plays. Right? It kind of comes that old Navy SEAL, you know, saying, right? You know, you don't rise to the occasion, you sink to the level of your training. And that's, in basketball, it's not necessarily a bad thing, right? I mean, guys, you know, they want to step up, they want to be the hero, they want to put the team on their back, which is great. But usually just ends up in you know, less than great shots. And a lot of times you're better off just to, you know, slow down, calm down, execute, make simple plays, and trust your teammates to do their jobs.
Yeah, a bit of a frantic pace there. A lot of steals and turnovers going on as well. There's not a lot of executed possessions.
There hasn't been a very high value on possession with the basketball in the last few minutes.
Yeah.
I think that's the polite way to put it.
Yeah. A scrambly pace, we'll say. Ball's inbounded for the Irish. Kyle Tejada and Ben Levy in for Shaders. Holt from the high post. No good. Good defense by Mathers. Offensive board by the Irish. Holt double teamed. Handled easily. He looks to attack, and he will finish over Logan Mathers.
Yeah, even splitting, you know, with bringing the double and splitting that third defender, Holt's just so long and athletic that if he catches deep or gets the ball in the paint there, Holy Cross really just doesn't have an answer physically on the roster.
Holt also doing a good job on the defensive end of contesting shots without picking up fouls and keeping his body out of it. And straight up.
Finley was his third foul of the evening.
As Levy bobbles it out of bounds.
Holy Cross backing the pressure off here a little bit.
Pull up jumper, no good. Rebounded by Mathers.
Good job by Holy Cross icing the ball screen, baiting College into a tough contested jumper going baseline.
Brandon Fuchs returns for the Crusaders. Logan Mathers will take a breather. Padilla backs down Cruz Dumont. It's where Padilla shows his poise and experience when you need a basket. Holt inside. Ola Gola gets caught up in the air. And he'll draw the foul on Ola Gola, perhaps. Nope. It'll be on White 14. Not sure who that is.
I think he probably meant 13.
Okay.
Well, Grosco got a little lucky there. They could have very easily called the first one there on Agala.
Well, Agala got caught up at jumping. So Holt misses the first. 6-point lead, 1 minute to go in the third quarter. 8-minute quarters here at the BC Catholic Championships.
Yeah, it definitely changes the dynamic from the regular game. And basically, you're losing essentially a quarter. Your depth is not quite as important or as it may be in a regular game, or you know, we may see in the regular season or through playoffs, etc. So for teams that are a little bit deeper, rely on that depth, you know, like Holy Cross generally does. You know, some of those, you lose a little bit of that advantage.
So Hunter Cruz-Dumont will go to the line to shoot two. He's 2 for 2 on the night from the line. Looking to remain perfect here. James Marujo checks in for Holy Cross, and Padilla will take a break.
Just following up there, we were talking about those 8-minute quarters. You know, for a team like College, it definitely right now is an advantage for them, where they're able to ride their starting backcourt a little bit more and not have to worry about going to the secondary ball handlers quite as much.
Jacob! Under!
Ogola, pump fakes, looks to pass it out. Great defense by Holt. And he'll get called for the five-second count.
Hey!
Great defense there by Jacob Holt. Cruz Dumont for three. No good. Rebounded by Cole Cruz Dumont. Over to Holt. He'll shoot the three. No good. Coach not liking that shot selection. Levy goes right at Holt. And he'll miss the layup. We've got a jump ball. Brave take there by Ben Levy.
Yeah, you know, Chow is a big guy. Holy Cross looking for a basket interference call there, but you're not going to get that.
To be fair, the backboard was swinging, but
yeah,
but did disrupt the shot, I guess.
I don't think it really. I think the shot was already off the glass by that point. Didn't hit rim, but at the same time, that's not a call that I think you see correctly made very often in BC high school basketball.
Ola-gola to end the quarter. So 48-43. We've got a close one. This one's going down to the wire.
Vancouver College Fighting Irish.
Yeah, I mean, great third quarter from college. You know, Holy Cross backing out the pressure definitely helped Fighting Irish guards there in that third quarter. You know, they're able to move the ball pretty freely and find holes inside a lot, you know, with quick regularity. You know, Holy Cross, I think, also a little bit lucky. College hasn't been very good from the foul line tonight. You know, a little more consistent from the free throw line. This could be a little bit more, a fairly comfortable lead. For the Fighting Irish, yeah. Instead of just a two-point, instead we're still in a two-possession game, and anyone can grab it at this point.
So Hunter Cruz Dumont really started to cook there in the third quarter. Only 4 points in the first half, and now he's up to 11. So he's starting to make his impact on the game.
Yeah, good job getting out, running in transition, and you know, getting on the offensive glass. You know, just a lot of effort and a lot of hustle, and you know, that's kind of what college needs out of some of those younger guards. It's just, you know, again, you know, you don't have to be Kobe, you don't have to be LeBron. You just have to go do your job and play hard, and good things will happen.
So for the Crusaders, it's mostly Uiagalelei, 18 points through three quarters, and Brent Padilla with 11 points through three quarters. I've been doing the scoring for the Crusaders, so they're hoping to get someone else to step up. Last game in the semifinals, Kyle Tejada had a huge game, hitting a lot of threes, and he's so far been left off the score sheet.
Yeah, it's been a quiet night for Tejada so far. Loose ball foul on the Crusaders there.
So Ola-gola picks up his third. Cruz Dumont, turnaround jumper, good.
Yeah, it's a nice baseline set. The college has run a couple of different times, curling the shooter out to the corner and then flashing the original guy in the middle. College, or Crusaders, have had a hard time dealing with that again because they're so concerned about what Holt slipped into the rim after that first ball screen. First off ball screen, sorry.
No answer for Ola-gola. 20 points on the Knights. Lobbed into Holt.
Off-target pass. Holt almost comes up with it before the ball gets turned over to the Crusaders. Really here, it's going to come down to, I think, who can string together two or three stops in a row. And both teams have showed that they can score, then get to the free throw line a little bit.
Crusaders look to settle things here. 8 seconds to go on the shot clock. Pull-up jumper, Levy. No good. Rebounded by nobody. Back over to Marujo. Blocked by Holt. Irish in transition.
Yeah, bringing the ball up with your inside hand and trying to stretch it out over Holt is probably not going to be a very successful option for the Crusaders here in the fourth quarter.
Padilla and Fujimura return for the Crusaders.
Fuchs with his third there. Looks like we'll see Marujo back in the game here shortly.
And the Crusaders only got four. Oh, no, they got five. Okay, never mind. So Anim checks in. We've got Anim, Fujimura, Olagola, Fuchs, and Padilla for the Crusaders. Cruz Dumont, Chong, Soriano, Holt, and Cruz Dumont for the Irish. Crossbar pass to Soriano. Drives. It'll count. Soriano with the and one. So he hasn't been a three-point threat from the outside, but he'll do it the old-fashioned way.
Yeah, and a little bit of a breakdown there with the Crusaders. They haven't been guarding Soriano 3.9 or 3.9 all night. On the catch there, come out a little off-balance, a little too quick, and get beat off the dribble.
So Fuchs with his fourth foul as Soriano misses the free throw. Tipped around by Olagola. Grabbed by Fuchs. Crusaders in transition. Olagola draws the foul. Can't connect. Sure doesn't take long for the Crusaders to get down the floor and make you pay if you're not getting back in transition.
That's his fourth personal foul.
No, good job getting there off of this ball. Getting up and running. And Crusaders do a pretty good job of, not stopping themselves in transition. They're going to make you stop the ball. So even if you have a couple bodies back, no one's going to step up and actually, talk and contain the dribbler. They'll just keep going to the rim until you do.
Olagola, 6-for-7 from the line on the night.
Lacrosse extend the pressure up here a little bit. 1-2-2.
Chong for three. No good. Crusaders trying to jump on the ball. Can't. Hunter Cruz Dumont takes a hard hit. Driving to the hoop. No call. Crusaders right back at him and blocked by Holt as Cruz Dumont will take it the other way for two.
Cruz Dumont got up just in time to find himself wide open for a layup.
You want action. You got action here. Inside to Fuchs or to Fujimura. Olagola, pull up. No good. Rebounded by Anim.
Rebound call!
Spin move, Padilla. Spin move again. He gets called for the travel.
On the Crusaders, Iris ball.
Padilla pretty adamant he didn't switch it or drag his pivot foot there. But again, it's hard to expect to get that call of the crowd.
So a war of attrition here in the final game of the BC Catholics. Cruz Dumont, nice take. That'll count.
That zone pressure's not doing very well for Holy Cross so far. College able to reverse the ball and find the middle pretty open.
So Cruz Dumont, 13 points in the second half. To the corner, Fujimura back out to Anim. Fujimura pulled the three, count it! Big shot by Fujimura. 56-50. Irish lead, 4 minutes to go.
So that'd be four on two.
Five. He's done. Tough call for Brandon Fuchs there. As Logan Mathers checks back in. So Fujimura, having coached him in the past, he is not afraid to take that big shot.
No, I mean, and it was a good shot with time winding down. He's on balance, he's in rhythm, he was contested, but you're not going to get a better one without 500 from the shot clock.
So Crusaders opt for the 2-3 zone and force the turnover and the foul. And him shaken up.
Foul on number 15, Jacob Holtz.
So that's Holt's first foul on the night. Unbelievable.
Yeah, Holt's done he's done a pretty good job of using his legs, not letting guys get into his body and avoiding picking up anything cheap on the other end. The referees have also probably helped him out a little bit. There's a couple times where bodies have hit the floor, but Holt's done a pretty good job of good defensive position, taking that contact on the chest, and the officials have allowed him to play.
Turnover by the Crusaders. Not the possession they were hoping for after their hard work on defense, but TNM looks to get it back. Can't quite come up with it. As they took 1 second off the clock, it looks like. 2 seconds off the clock. On that possession. Cross-court pass. Jackson Finley blocked by Padilla.
Yeah, a little miscommunication there. It was picking up the middle for like Crosby, Padilla or Olegala, but Padilla hustling back and making a good play.
Three ball! Good for Anim. Big shot by T. Anim. 3-point game. 3:30 to go. BC Catholic Championship on the line. Cruz Dumont dishes to Finley. Blocked by Olegala. He got up there in a hurry. Fans going crazy. Jason Soriano checks back in. Wow, what a block by Olegala.
Yeah, it was a good job. Here's throwing the ball on the backside there. Taking away what looked like it was going to be an easy layup for the Irish.
Baseline drive, drift pass. Back up to Soriano. He'll drive. No call. And turnover. Crusaders coming back the other way. Olegala in transition. Right out of Holt. No good. Ball stolen at center. Adam drives in the lane, bobbles it, back out to Fujimura, he'll shoot again, no good, rebounded by the Irish, 56-53, Irish lead as Padilla picks up the foul, his fourth,
the crowd definitely doesn't like that one, but it was a good call.
So we're in the penalty, so Irish will go to the line. Shoot two. Michael Chong.
This is Chong's first trip to the line tonight.
So he'll sink both to extend the lead to five.
I'm pretty sure it's the first time the Irish have gone 2-for-2 from the line this evening.
That could come back to bite them if they don't maintain this lead. Olegala stolen by Cruz Dumont. Lots of dribbling there for the Crusaders. High post, high low action to Jacob Holt. Blocked by Mathers. And Tiannin goes the other way for two as the Irish ask for a timeout. Coach Lloyd Scrub is on the court asking for a timeout, even though the buzzer had not rung or had it. It's so loud in here, it's hard to hear anything. It's almost like CenturyLink Field in Seattle.
Yeah, the officials just couldn't hear the horn. Sport Cable's probably got it hit a couple more times there. Coach Presente and Coach Joss are not happy that Coach Scrub was out in the middle of the court.
That was a little crazy, actually.
But, he did have the timeout in place. Officials just coming over and referring with the table here about what kind of time to add back to the game clock.
So that block down here by Mathers looked like it could have been goaltending. It almost was like a rebound that he swatted off the backboard.
Yeah, it was coming down off the glass. It's hard to tell from our angle here if he had already hit the rim before he had touched it or not. I mean, if it had hit the rim, then, you know, it's legal. As a coach, though, I think, you know, if it was me on the Irish bench, I would have been more upset. I would have less upset about the possible missed call. I'm more upset about the majority of my players just stopping competing and just playing to the refs while Anna went coast to coast for a layup.
Came right back in a hurry. That was a quick 2-point turnaround. And then the timeout situation here. Yeah. Irish looking a little rattled here. So they're still got a 3-point lead. And definitely Crusaders with the momentum in the last 30 seconds to a minute.
Yeah, it's been a quick turn here. We'll see what they do. They can keep this going. They've got the Irish been a little bit quicker than they're comfortable with.
They did blow it. Yeah.
So fans are on their feet here for the last 2 minutes of action. 3-point game. Irish leading 58-55. Let's see how this plays out.
Holy Cross extending back full court man, which has definitely been a little more successful for them than that 1-2-2.
Tagging off of Soriano. Chong guarded tightly by Anim.
Yeah, well, it's a really good
cross court pass to Soriano. And he flips it up, no good. Gets his own rebound from the ground, and he kicks it out to Hunter Cruz Dumont.
Yeah, great heads up play by Soriano, picking out finding the open teammate.
Pull up jumper from the elbow, no good. Great rebound, Fujimura. Big possession here for the Crusaders. Gola, pump fakes, corner three, Padilla, it's good! Huge basket, Brent Padilla for three, ties the game.
It's got a quick whistle here, game clock ran after the main basket. We're going to put 1 minute back on the clock.
Could you ask for anything more in a final game?
No, big shot by Padilla, good job by Olagala, getting in the paint, drawing help. And just played that drawn kick with his longtime high school and club teammate, Padilla.
Holy goal actually had Jacob Holt up in the air on the drive. Chose to kick it out. Padilla showing poise, knocking down the three. Here we go. Under 1 minute to go. Tie game. Cruz Dumont. Guarded by Olagola. Crowd is loud. Standing. Soriano in the corner, inside to Holt, stolen, Olagola. Uwe in transition, and he finishes. He's cooking.
Again, the clock ran after the basket. We bring it back and see if the Irish are going to call a timeout here.
Tianim looking to get the fans hyped. 2-point lead for the Crusaders. Well, the referees and the game crew sort out the time on the clock. Time needs to stop after a mid-basket in the last 2 minutes.
The Irish have a couple timeouts here. Let's see if they want to take one and advance the ball.
Hunter Cruz Dumont looks to talk things over with his coach. And Coach Roy Scrub thinks this needs a timeout. He'll talk things over.
Yeah, I mean, you almost had a free timeout there with the stop anyway, but it's not a bad idea. Now, you know, the Irish can choose where they want to advance the ball or take it from the backcourt, but to be able to get everyone on the same page, make sure you guys are ready to execute. And also at this point, too, we're down into basically a one-possession game so talking about making sure players are aware that, you know, if we do miss, we're going, whether you're going to go steal or foul, or you're going to foul right away, or what your defensive strategy is going to be after this shot attempt.
This crowd's going bananas here. One of the best high school atmospheres in the province, hands down.
Yeah, it's always a good turnout. It's always, you know, the fans here. It's also, it's a good community event. We've got some school, high schools from across, most schools across the province. I know this year with weather, some things, some teams were forced to change their plans, so it ended up being mostly just a lower mainland event. But when you get your kids that have, whether they compete against each other, not just in other sports, but, you know each other from other avenues of church and things like that. So you have all these different connections. So it does make it for a pretty special event for the kids, for sure.
For sure. Here we go. 30 seconds to go. Holy Cross, 60. Vancouver College, 58. BC Catholic Championships on the line. Stolen by Olegola. In transition. Pound the bucket. Are you kidding me? Uri Olegola. Huge basket. It'll count. 9.8 seconds to go. That may be the nail in the coffin.
It definitely should be. I mean, Holy Cross definitely waiting for that, you know, sitting on that high-low entry into hole in the post. You know, Golly, you can see it coming. You know, picked up the steal. The second time in the last minute or so, they've managed to get the steal off that same entry.
Disqualifying foul for number 14.
So, last one was on Soriano, so it'll be done for the evening.
As Parsa Haydarzadeh checks in for Vancouver College for the final 9.8 seconds. So let's see if Olegola can convert the and one. Irish looking to score quick. Cruz Dumont. Tough hoop, but it'll go. 1 point game. Timeout, Holy Cross. So we have got, how much time was on the clock after?
4.1 seconds. See if they add any time to it. Unfortunately for the Fighting Irish here, their biggest challenge is they've only got three team fouls. So really, they need to come up with a steal and get the go the way to the floor in this 4 seconds. You know, because if the Clears manage to get the ball inbound, or inbounded, by the time you pick up those two fouls, really there's going to be no time left
on the clock.
Take off
at least 2-3 seconds, yeah, you're going to have a second. Although, you could just lob it into Holt, and
this is true.
Could work. So we'll see what their what the plan is. Crusaders hoping to just kill the clock, really. And
yeah, I mean, Holy Cross, their whole priority at this point is get the ball inbound, and, you know, at this point, you know, we'll see if they make any subs or bring in any other stronger free throw shooter. It looks like they're going to come back with the same same lineup.
I think Kyle Tejada is checked in for Anum.
Checked in for Anum.
Get a shooter on the floor in case he gets fouled. Fujimura will dribble it out. And he'll get a foul with only 0.3 left. So that should do it here.
Yeah, it was a great decision by Fujimura there. Put the ball on the floor, dribble out the clock instead of taking the layup. You know, giving College a shot with, you know, 3 or so seconds left for a desperation three after a timeout.
It looks like they'll put up 1.1 on the clock. So
yeah, so again, if you're Holy Cross, you're at this point, you just want to get the ball in safely. And if you can, you know, you tip.
Do you miss the free throws and just kill the clock, or
you know, it
score if give them a chance to advance?
1.1, I mean, yeah, I mean, you're going to miss the second one there, not give them a chance to advance the ball.
Yeah, really no way you can get the ball down the floor to get a shot with 1.1.
Yeah.
But with the timeout advance of the ball, still one possession.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, if you hit both here at 1.1, it's, you know, it's crazier things have happened than a catch and shoot three at 1.1 seconds. So you're definitely, you're going to want to make the first you can. If you miss the second, or miss the second, and just really hope that you hit rim and don't violate.
Yeah. Well, we'll see what happens here.
But before we get to that, Holy Cross, you got to get the ball inbound safely here.
Oh, they still need one more foul. So, yeah.
Yeah.
Holy Cross throws the ball in off the Irish here. We're going to take a little bit of time off the clock. Looks like we're at 0.7. Looks like Padilla going live with 0.1 seconds left, so it really doesn't matter. If he makes both, misses both here, whatever.
So the last...
Actually, I guess I shouldn't say that here. You're going to want to miss the second one. Yeah, if he didn't make it 0.1 seconds, you still could get that tip to hold.
Off the rim, yeah. And that'll do it. So, your 2020 BC Catholic Basketball Champions, the Holy Cross Crusaders, with the five-peat.
Yeah, it was a very well played game, competitive game all the way through. You can see how much it matters to players and fans having a good celebrating. Also, the highest Coach Pazente's got up since his high school playing game, playing days himself, celebrating after there. The fifth year in a row these teams have matched up in the final. It's 5 years in a row Holy Cross has won.
5 years, yeah. The last 5 years, it's been a Holy Cross Vancouver College final with Holy Cross coming out on top. The last time it wasn't Holy Cross was 2015, which Vancouver College won.
Yeah, so it's been a really good run here in the tournament for the Crusaders. Both these teams are now move on to the Holy Cross for their South Fraser North League play, Irish to the Independent League, and then to the Sea to Sky playoffs. See if these two teams match up again. I'm sure they would be happy to see each other again in March at the Langley Event Center. And best luck to both these teams going forward.
So exciting final as always. Thanks for tuning in. And I think that'll do it for the broadcast for tonight. So thank you once again. And we'll see you next year.